Welcome to EEMS 320. This video provides a brief overview of the basic steps to set up a basic hydrodynamics model from scratch using EFDC Explorer, visualize and extract model outputs, and add sediment to the hydrodynamics model. Let's get started. These data files are necessary for building the model. They include bathymetric data, flow and water level data, meteorological data, sediment concentration data, and some other kinds of data. To generate a new model, go to the Model menu and then select New Model. In the Grid Generation window, select the Import Grid from Files radio button and then browse to the grid file named chakut.cvl. Enter 49 for the UTM zone box to set the geographic zone for the model, and then click OK. After generating the model, the user should save the model by clicking on the Save Active Model button from the toolbar or selecting Save Model under the Model menu. The Select Directory Write Options form will allow the user to select the write options and model format, as well as the location to save. For a newly generated model, the full write option is recommended. From the model control form, the user can expand the initial conditions tree to see the list of initial conditions. First, right-click on Bathymetry to open the Bathymetry form. Here, the Assign button can be used to begin assigning cell properties. In this example, we'll use an XYZ data file to define bathymetry in the model. Use the Scatter XYZ radio button and add the bathymetry.dat file. Click on Apply Defined Conditions to set the bottom elevation of the model. Right-click on Water Depths and Elevations to open the Water Depths and Elevations form. Here, the Assign Elevations button can be used to begin assigning cell properties. In this example, we will again use an XYZ data file to define the initial water surface elevations in the model. Use the Scatter XYZ radio button and add the ic_wsel.dat file. Click on Apply Defined Conditions to assign the initial water surface elevation to the model. In this step, we will import flow data into the model and assign it to the upstream inflow cell. To do this, from the model control form, go to the external forcing data tree on the left. Right-click on flow and select Add New Data Series from the pop-up menu. From the data series editor, the user can create a new flow time series. Click on the Add New button to add a new data series. Then select the Import Data Series button. In the ASCII data import form that pops up, first browse to the bc_flow.dat file in the Boundaries folder and select the data format as EEDAT or WQDATA. Next, modify the import settings parameters and click OK to import the data series. Once the options have been configured, click OK to finish importing the data. Now, we are going to assign boundary conditions for the open boundary cells by using harmonic constituents. To do this, from the model control form, go to the external forcing data tree on the left and click on the harmonic tides. Select Add New Data Series from the pop-up menu. In the harmonic forcing form that pops up, first select Add New Data. You can name the new series Tides. Next, we will add harmonic constituents by clicking the Change button and then selecting the constituents listed in the harmonic constants data file. After adding the constituents, users can configure the amplitude and phase of each constituent. First, the user needs to define the cells and associate the external forcing time series for each boundary. Open the 2DH view and turn on the Boundaries layer in the Layer Control. To add inflows to multiple cells, go to the Selection tool and select Line Crossing. Then, draw a line to cross all 17 cells at the upstream end of the grid. Right-click on one of these cells and select Add New Boundary Group. The Add BC Group form will appear. The user should put a name for the boundary, such as Inflow, and select Flow for boundary group type. Click OK to create the inflow boundary and bring up the Flow Boundary Condition Editor. Here, the user should click on the Flow Table drop-down menu from the Forcing Assignments frame and select the Inflow series. Next, click the All button to apply to all 17 grid cells in the boundary group. Then, click OK to finish linking the flow series to the BC group and close the form. Next, assign boundary conditions to the open boundary cells. From the Selection tool, select Inside Polygon, then left mouse click to start drawing a polygon that can cover all of the cells at the open boundary location. Right mouse click to end the drawing, and then all cells inside the polygon will be selected. Right click on one of these cells and select Add New Boundary Group. The Add BC Group form will appear. The user should put a name for the group, such as Ocean, and select East Open Boundary for boundary group type. Click OK to create the open boundary and bring up the Open Boundary Condition Editor. Here, the user should click on the Harmonic Data drop-down menu in the current boundary cell frame and select the Tide series. Next, click the All button to apply to all cells in the group. Then, click OK to finish linking the Tide series to the BC group. To set the number of water layers, go to the Model Grid tree in the Model Control form. Right-click on Layers and the Model Grid form will appear. Here, we will select Standard Sigma from the drop-down list for water layers and enter 5 for the number of layers. Hydrodynamic settings can be configured to optimize the simulation time and model stability. There are some different parameters which are divided into subtabs, including numerical options, turbulence, roughness, shallow water, wind forcing, Coriolis effect, density effects factor, and vegetation. In the Turbulence Diffusion tab, set the parameters as shown. Parameters must also be adjusted in the Turbulent Intensity tab. The bottom roughness values must be set as well. Right-click on Roughness to open the bottom roughness form. Here, the Assign button can be used to begin assigning cell properties. In this example, we'll use an XYZ data file to define bottom roughness in the model. Use the Scatter XYZ radio button and add the bottomroughness.dat file. Click on Apply Defined Conditions to set the bottom roughness for the model. Next, we'll set the shallow water settings. Right-click on Shallow Water to open the Shallow Water Options form. Select the third option from the drop-down menu. Enter the value for the dry depth and wet depth. Note that the wet depth should always be greater than the dry depth. Next, we will set the model timing. Under the Timing and Linkage tree of the Model Control form, there are four tabs. The first allows the user to set the simulation time of the model. Linkage allows the user to set the frequency and output parameters. And third, Restart Options allows the user to set the restart and continuation mode run options. Number four, the Ramp Up Options, allows the user to set and modify the timing to full transition physics. In the main frame of the timing options, the user must specify the reference state, the time period to start and end the run, along with the time stepping options and duration of the period. The dynamic time step option subframe allows the users to engage auto stepping by setting the safety factor to a positive value between 0 and 1. If set to 0, it will result in a fixed time step. It should be noted that EFDC Plus will use multiples of the time step when dynamic time stepping is on. right-click on the Linkage subtab to set the output frequency. Under EFDC Explorer Linkage tab, set the linkage output frequency to 60, so that the outputs will be written every 60 minutes in the simulation. Before running the model, the input file should be saved using the full write option. To prepare a simulation to be run, use the Run EFDC Plus button from the toolbar. In the Run Options form, specify the number of threads to be used in the simulation and the version of EFDC Plus to be used. Now that the simulation is complete, we can start visualizing model outputs. Before visualizing model outputs, after each simulation run, users should update the outputs by using the Refresh Output button from the toolbar. In EE, there are some different options that allow users to visualize the model output. First, visualize the model output in plan view with the 2DH view. Next, visualize the model output in time series with the time series plot. In this option, the user should select grid cells first and then select the parameters to plot. After that, visualize the model outputs in time series using the longitudinal profile plot. This function allows the users to visualize the model outputs of a column, a row, or a specified drape line. Finally, visualize the model outputs in time series with the vertical slice and vertical profile tools. This section provides instructions to activate the sediment module from the previous hydrodynamic model. To activate the sediment module, right-click on the module header in the model control form. Select the original cohesive sediments and original non-cohesive modules. After the module is activated, sediment will be displayed in the list of modules under the module tree. Settings can be accessed through the menu, which appears when right-clicking on the sediment branch. Once the sediments and sediment bed properties form appears, in the major settings frame, enter 4 for the number of sediment bed layers, 1 for the number of cohesives, and 3 for the number of non-cohesives. In the General tab, set the time to start calcs equal to 220 to fit with the model timing. Next, under the Cohesives tab, the user opens the sedimentsettings.xlsx file in the Boundaries folder and then refers to the information from the cohesive sheet to fill in the cohesive inputs. Take a similar approach as the Cohesive tab for non-cohesive suspended, Morphology and Consolidation and Initial Conditions tab by referring to inputs from the sedimentsettings.xlsx file. Next, fill in the settings for non-cohesive bed load and bed processes tab by following the given training document. For the sediment model, sediment must be assigned to each boundary condition. Atmospheric and wind data should also be added to the model if they are available. To create these data series, the user can access the Wind, Atmospheric, and Sediment, Non-Cohesive, and Cohesive Sediment tab under the External Forcing Data tab. After adding the new cohesive and non-cohesive sediment time series, the next step is assigning the series to the boundary cells in the model domain. To do this, edit the boundary groups and link the groups to the sediment time series. After linking the sediment time series to the boundary group, save the model again. The model is now ready to run. Click on the Run EFDC Plus button from the EE main toolbar and configure and begin the model run. After the model run is completed, click the Refresh Model Output button to update the model output. we can take a look at how the addition of sediment to the model has changed the results using the 2DH view, or view temperature of selected cells, with a feature such as view time series and longitudinal profile plot. View vertical profile . Thank you for watching. You can view the next EEMS training video by following the link below.